Hello YouTube, welcome back to Transport Fever. And you guys are probably thinking, first thing, hang on a minute, this isn't a new series, this is just the same old, you said you were binning this series, or the series had ended. Yes, this series has ended. The reason I've got a video coming out with this particular map is that the map that I'm trying to make, or the map that Pixelator is also trying to make, it's taking a long time. I want it to be perfect, it needs to have the right balance. I'm not going to reveal what the map is. If you want to know what the map is, Patreon, my patrons have access, they know exactly what the map is, and they know what the plan is, and Pixelator also knows what it is, because I needed him to make the map, because I don't have that much time to make the map. So, what I've decided is that for this one, this is going to be an extra video, and I'm just going to have a look at the new performance update. So the performance patch is out, and I'm just going to test what it is like. So I'll tell you what. First thing we need to do is let's have a look at the way the lag is in, say, an area like this. I know there's a train coming this way, I just saw one. And there's a train waiting there, and there's two trains out on the side. So, I mean, in pause, it's very, very smooth. A lot smoother than it used to be. So, let's have a look like this. Well, that's very laggy. Let's do this as well. Because I'm just going to take a screenshot as it comes up. Oh no, wait, that's not laggy anymore. I mean, it is a little bit, but it's fairly smooth. Actually, I'm not going to take a screenshot because I want to show something else. Actually, that's pretty smooth with two trains crossing. I mean, it's not brilliant, but I can say that's alright. Let's see if this Chagford train gets moving. Come on. Come on. Anytime now. What are you waiting for? Don't tell me there's another one coming through. Yeah, I think there is. I can hear it. That's what he was waiting for. That's not bad. I will say that is not bad. Okay, surely it should have gone now. Now what are you waiting for? Now it's waiting for that one. Well, this is a good place to start an extra video. But, I mean, yeah. So, the performance seems to be better in this area. What we're going to do is we're going to go over to Canterbury next. Now go. As soon as this train moves. Go. 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 Oh, come on. What are you waiting for now? This is ridiculous. Here comes another train. Oh, now it's going. Now it's going. That was the longest wait ever. Now, should I ever carry this series on? I think I know what I'm going to do. I need to fix that. I will be fixing that. Okay, well, that's alright. It's a lot easier to move, actually. Let's bring that back up. It's a lot easier to move around. Let's have a look in Canterbury, I said. Let's have a look at that goods yard of ours. How's the frames around here? Still got that lag at the end of month, you can see it. 200 and... come on. 259 out of 276, that's not too bad. Alright. That's actually a lot better. That is a lot better, I will say that. I'd say that's probably a 15% improvement, or thereabouts, in terms of what the frames were like. And we can still see a little bit of jitter there as it's trying to work itself out. And yeah, I mean, it's not the most optimized of games, we all know that. But I can say that this is okay. Yeah, this is okay. Okay, well, Should I make this the length of a normal episode? This is only 5 minutes in. I think maybe I'll make this a length of a normal episode, but we won't be doing much work on it. The other thing I want to do... there's some lag. Watch this. Pause. Right. That's not the train I want, though. When I find a train that I want in... Yes, we're going to do this in paused mode. That one. In fact, we shall... Yes! Yep, that one. We'll play it a little bit. And we'll pause it right there. So you can see the lag when we're coming out of pause. You can see the lag. Now, watch this. First of all, if we click this, this has changed. You can see this. This has changed a little bit. So, yeah, you can just remove stations at will quite easily. But it's got this. This has changed. You can remove all the stations if you want. If we go to replacement, it's got this as replacement. You can actually change your replacement vehicle in this fashion now. You can also do replace now, which will just change the trains immediately, which is great. I think that's awesome. And yeah, that's quite a bit going on. In fact, is that seriously we can... Oh no. I was going to say, could we replace that one at a time? Because if we could, that would be absolutely fantastic. That's something they need to do, one at a time replacement. So each train can have its own colours and all that kind of stuff. So there's that. The other thing that I really like, and this is going to be heavily featured in the next series, is this. So, you can see that I now have a camera. Right, and you think, well, that's, yeah, that's alright, but the best part about this is... this. Where is it? This one. 35mm camera, 55, 85, 135 or 400. Look at that. I mean, that obviously looks a bit stupid. But we can go for a 35mm camera and we bring it down, bring it in. It gives you an impression or of an actual camera. I love that, the way it does the way it's got the zoom and the way it's got the focal length. That's brilliant. This focal length option is really, really nice. So there we go. We could take a picture like that if we wanted to. And press that and I suppose take a picture. It's because user data screenshots. I don't know whether that's, you know, the one. And there you go. And then you just continue along the way. I mean, we'll find out what that does, but it's not bad. It is not bad. Okay, so we've had a look at that. We've had a look at this camera mode. Things seem to be okay. There aren't any new industries or anything, are there? No new industries. That's all fine. Let's have a look at this. Trackside objects. What have we got? Lights. I don't remember them being lights. In fact, I did notice that on something, actually. Have a look at this. Right. As you can see, the Mallard doesn't have any... or the Class A4 doesn't have any lights at the front. Now, I don't know. Someone needs to tell me whether there were or were not before. But have a look at the front of the Class A3. Lights. I don't remember lights on the front of a Class A3 before. So I don't know whether they're building towards nighttime or... I haven't got a clue. I really, really haven't got a clue. Double track lighting. Look at that. Stick it right in the middle. That's awesome. That is really, really awesome. It's a shame it doesn't snap in the middle of these, but... I mean, that is really cool. What do they look like? Are they like lit up or anything? No, they're not lit up. So no, they're not lit up, but still, that's pretty awesome. You've got noise barriers as well. Look at that. Stick noise barriers on. Obviously, for something like this, it'd probably have to be in a much smaller form, but... I mean, I've seen these before. I'm not saying that I haven't seen these before. Of course, I have seen these before. You know, that's looking pretty good. And the thing is, I never used to put any of these on for the simple reason was I didn't want to cause any more issues by adding more assets. But if the performance is increased and is better, then perhaps it means that I'll be able to, in the next series this is, which is coming, don't worry, it is coming soon. But I should be able to, for example, do things like that the whole way through. So, you know, you can have that kind of stuff, or some railings, or I don't know, just a bunch of stuff. Look, we've got all these. If we could put a wooden... That wooden fence is very tiny, I'll be honest. But, you know, whatever we could, we'll be able to really work on getting rocks and trees and all those kind of things put into the game, which would be really, really awesome. Like I said, I don't want to give too much away about the next series. In fact, I'm not going to give anything away about the next series. The next series is going to be a secret, and a secret it shall remain until such a time where it does not need to be a secret anymore, which should hopefully be next week. This time, I'm hoping this time next week, I should have the first episode coming out. Or would it be this time next week? Yes, it will be this time next week as when this video is being released. So it should be released on a Wednesday. So we should have it. Yeah, next Wednesday we should have the start of the next series. Anything else I need to really say? I don't think so. The performance update does seem to be working. I mean, look, that's a lot smoother now. As I say that, it has a bit of lag, but that is a fair amount smoother. And, you know, it's nothing incredible. It's nothing like no major changes, but it's good enough. As in, it's a good start. They need to work on it more. I'm not going to say, oh, wow, this is absolutely perfect. They do need to work on it more. Just as I would ideally have had to work on this more, because, you know, the amount of people, actually, 49. Never mind. I just want to see how much this one picks up. I say it's probably going to pick up around 100. Let's find out. Quick on the eyes here. Everyone, quick on the eyes. It went down to 28. 77. It's a bit poor. 78, 79. 80. 81. 82, 83. 83. I think they've also improved the deceleration rates of the train. So let's have a look for when the next train's coming in. I don't think that one's coming into the next stop, is it? No, it doesn't stop here. That one's going all the way on to somewhere else. Here, isn't it? But yeah, I think they've improved the deceleration rates of the train, so we should see in the next series they'll be slowing down a lot better. Here we go, this one. Let's keep an eye on this one. But yeah, I think that brings me to the end of this extra video. I just wanted to see the performance update, make sure I get a Transport Fever video out for you guys, so you guys actually, you know, you've got something. You're not like, oh my god, where's Transport Fever gone? This guy is useless, I'm unsubscribing. Quick, you know, doesn't make any videos that I want anymore. Still a bit of lag. There you go. You do see that lag there. The freeze frame. Thank you very much for watching. Please remember to hit the like button if you like this video. Subscribe to the channel, like I said, for another series of Transport Fever. No, that's still breaking very late. It needs to break a lot earlier than that. Yeah, leave a comment in the comments box below. Let me know what you think of the performance update. If you've tried it, if you've got it, do you think that it's improved things? I think it has, not in drastic amounts, but I think it's a start. It's pretty good, and I think there needs to be more, but for now, I think we're pretty good with where we are. Don't forget to check me out on Patreon. Link to that is in the description box below. The support there would be massively appreciated. If you haven't seen my Hypercar Showdown and are interested in cars, do check that video out. That is a sort of a teaser as to what I could do with Patreon support. If I was supported on Patreon, that's the kind of videos I would be able to make, not just in Assetto Corsa, but I'll be able to make that in other things. I'd be able to, you know, upgrade my computer, make longer episodes, more episodes, more series, and a whole bunch of really, really nice stuff. And that's obviously the goal. So, you know, if you can, do support me on there. It would be massively appreciated. Follow me on Twitch. Link to that is in the description box below. And do follow me on Twitter as well. Link to that is also in the description box below. Thank you very much for watching once again. And I will see you in the next series of Transport Fever.